Hello everyone, Simus here, and welcome back to Ark Survival Evolve. Now this is part one of what I'm calling Taming Day, which is basically, it's gonna be several episodes for you guys, but it's all gonna be probably one day for me. But I am basically just gonna go around and tame a whole bunch of things. Now as you can see, we do have a Gallimimus here. I'm not sure if we're gonna be able to get this guy, but I thought I would give it a shot, because this dead raptor here actually chased him into the rocks and he got stuck momentarily. So I'm hoping that if I can get around and get him to run the same way, we can have the same thing happen. Assuming that nothing attacks me and I can get in front of this thing. Okay, oop. This is the thing with galleys, they never stop moving. And I'm getting really far away from Shadow now. Alright, let's see if we can get this galley to run into those rocks. Nope, go the other way. This is worse than herding cats. Other way. Galleys are very noisy animals, have you noticed that? Okay, come on. Into position, keep going. Keep going. Don't turn. Turn back the other way. Basically, we want to try to get him stuck somewhere. Let's try it. You're gonna go towards the water, aren't you? They always go towards the water. This is why you really need to wait for them to get stuck, because they go all over the place. But we are now committed, so we're gonna do our best. Now, hopefully nothing attacks the mammoth, because it is on passive right now. And, okay, that's gone. It was worth a shot. It was really in a good position, but I of course wanted to start the video and do all the introductions instead of just shooting it and talking later. So that's really my mistake. So in the meantime, we're gonna have to go back and get the mammoth before it gets attacked by something, because I really can't afford to lose him. So as you can see, well first of all, it is really bright. But I do have my raft over here, and I've got the mammoth. Basically, we're just roaming around looking for things worth taming. Unfortunately, that galley was originally stuck, like, right here. Oh, seems we picked up a compy. Now, this is one of the frustrating things about the mammoth, is that I have to keep stopping to empty all this wood. Because no matter what I do, he just keeps picking up a ton of it, and that ends up weighing us down at really bad moments. I was in the middle of a fight earlier and ended up encumbered, and that was pretty bad. So let's see what else we can find. There is an ape over here that I was thinking about taming. The only reason I haven't is that apes are passive tames, and I'm really bad at passive tames. We also don't have any apes. Kibble. They like snake egg kibble, titanoboas, and it's a little bit hard to come by snake eggs in general. So let's go ahead and raft a little bit further down. Who knows, maybe we'll find that galley again if it hasn't been killed by something. They are really frustrating to catch. And honestly, the last time I tamed a galley, it was because it was stuck. It takes a lot of patience to get them in position. Let's see, what's going on with this galley over here? Is this galley stuck? No. I'm not sure if it works the same way as on servers, but he was definitely not fleeing in the direction I had expected. Oh, there's that ape. Let's go ahead and see if we can figure out where that galley went. Are you in here? You are in here. Alright. This is the galley we were just shooting, wasn't it? Yeah. Let's see if maybe we can just take advantage of this situation. Assuming we don't kill it. I really don't trust that dragonfly. Alright, so we are not doing as horribly as I thought we were. So we basically did get it stuck, just not in the spot where I had intended. So let's go up here. We are going to need to get some narcs very quickly. And some berries. Because galley torpor is insane. Like, not quite giga levels, but as you can see, we are going to have to be doing quite a bit of management on that front. And, oop. Don't want to get too close to the ape, because chances are it's going to decide it doesn't like me and try to hunt me. But we need to get this Dilo out of the way. Now the reason we want the galley out of the D-Lo out of the way is because we don't want it to attack the galley. Because galleys are, as you've noticed, extremely fragile. Let's look at his stats. Look at that, 240 HP and he's almost dead. Oh god. This is what I really don't like about apes. They seem to have this thing where they will walk all around your tame, and you can never tell exactly when they're gonna feel like actually turning around and just whacking you one. And I don't really want to kill them, because I would like to tame one of them. There is a level 16. And we're stuck on a rock. Mammoths are great in combat and for travel, except for the fact that they get stuck on every conceivable tree. And they don't just knock them down automatically. Okay. So as you can see, we can't really go too far with this tame, but we are going to try to gather up some fiber. In the heat of the moment earlier, I did manage to drop all of the fiber that I brought with me for making spike walls. So we don't have any spike walls. So we are just going to spend a few minutes. We're not going to go too far. So we are so bad. Now what? Shit. That was good. So yeah, this is why taming can occasionally be really frustrating, because I did not expect the mammoth AoE to hit the galley right there. So that's a fail on our part. There's this ape hanging around. Even think about hitting me, Mr. E. I don't even know what attacked us. What did we kill? It must have been a D-Lo. I don't know where the body went. Well, since we're here and the ape is here roaming around very close to us, I guess let's give it a shot. I'm not good at these tames at all, so this is probably going to be mostly me dying. Alright. So this is the extent of my knowledge about passive taming, is that you run up behind it, give it the berry, and then get away from it as fast as possible. Stop it! Stop turning where I'm trying to be. Alright. So level 12 should be around 20 minutes or so. Ooh, what is this? Parasaurite. We don't need it. I don't know what you're doing, but please... Nope. Stop it. Nope. Not hungry yet. Alright. This is the frustrating part, is that they're just gonna keep walking in circles because they know that we want to tame it. I don't know how long it takes for it to get hungry. And I don't know if these guys suffer from the same bug that the Gigantopithecus gets, the like the hunger bug. Nope, you're not hungry yet. But I actually didn't have one of those for the longest time, because every single time I tried to tame one, it would get that stupid bug and basically just its hunger would kind of switch places with HP and eventually would just die before you could tame it. Nope. Do not randomly turn around, please. Nope. How long do you take to get hungry? You better not go walking into the river. Okay. I don't know if Shadow is on passive or... Yeah. Let's go ahead and put you on neutral just in case. I'm not that worried about him, but... Assuming that the ape doesn't turn around and start wailing on him, but hopefully it'll stay around here. I don't know what their aggro range is either. I usually don't get too close to them on principle. It would be kinda nice if it got stuck on one of these rocks though. Noises at me. This is the part that's really stressful, is that I don't know. The timing on these seems a little bit sporadic. And since it's both rainy and foggy, we have to hope that there aren't any predators hanging around. Mission. Stop it. I'm hoping the ghillie suit is actually going to help with this tame, because this is kind of ridiculous. Really? You turn around while you're crouched? All I'm trying to do is feed you food. That doesn't mean you need to turn around and punch me in the face or something. Now see, if I'd had kibble, this would be done already. Yes, walk onto the raft. Do it. Walk onto the raft. No. I said on it, not next to it. That's really what makes these that's so difficult is that they randomly change direction. Please stop walking. Please stop walking. Not hungry yet. This takes so long. Like, this is on 5x taming, and I just feel like that's... Okay, one more. You'd think after a few berries it would just not aggro you anymore because you're being friendly and feeding it. But no. Yeah, in this video, I guess we're just gonna be staring at 8-butt for 20 minutes or so. Ooh, stop that. Ooh, look at that quetz. Actually, I have a quetz egg because one laid one while it was flying overhead. It got stuck in midair, but my mammoth was just tall enough that I could stand on him and get the egg. I thought that was kind of cool. Ooh, ooh, ooh. I'm starting to think the ghillie suit is really what's helping. But I don't really want to say anything about it just yet, because we still have quite a ways to go on this. Okay, another berry. And then back off. This is why the dung beetle is my favorite passive tame. You know why? Because they don't move, ever. You can just sit behind them and feed them until they are tame and they won't move. Standing in front of them is something else entirely, of course, but... I swear this is more stressful than when I'm taming a 120. Oh, you're not hungry yet. If we had some sort of clue as to when they were hungry again, that would be fantastic. Please don't get mixed up with this other one punting a D-Lo across the island. You saw nothing. Calm it down, calm it down. Ooh. This isn't suspicious at all. No, don't turn around. If these things could actually turn around, like, immediately, this would be basically impossible. Not that it's very easy right now. Getting there. Slowly. definitely not how I'd really wanted to do it. I had actually thought about doing this first, but then I saw that galley. So now we are going to conquer our fears with passive tames. After this, if we get this ape, that means the only passive tame left that I haven't done is the bat. And the bats are just beyond ridiculous. I'm not sure that I even want to try on one of those, but we might. So you're crouching to get food, but according to this thing, you're not actually hungry. There's a bronto egg over there. We're not gonna pick it up because we don't need it for anything. And the last thing we need is more angry brontos. Oop, there's a spino over there. Spinos are fine, they don't chase very far, and that's way over there. No. Okay, so I know you are hungry, so just stop moving, stop moving. I should qualify that with stop moving and don't turn around for 3 seconds. I've actually found 2 wild turtle eggs so far, speaking of eggs. The turtle was very unhappy about it, but I was. Just about halfway. We're actually doing better than I expected, honestly. But it's too early yet to celebrate. I have actually tamed some other stuff already today. We do have a replacement dodo, para, and trike. And I also picked up a packy while I was out because I saw one that was really cool colors. Whoa. That lag is terrifying when doing something like this. For a second, I was a little too close. Go back around. I can't even imagine doing this on default rates, like on an official. This low level is taking probably a good 25 minutes, and that's on Majos. But that's just a level 12. Can you imagine doing a 100 plus on berries? Insane. Stop that. Oh, I'm stuck on a rock. Turtle, please go away. This is a suspiciously circular pattern that we're walking in. Never mind. So you know how in other games, when you're trying to sneak around and you have guards patrolling around, if they were using these guys, Gigantopithecus, as the guards in their games, nobody would ever get by them. This is ridiculous. On the rocks. Ooh, 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 ooh. Pull back, pull back. Can't see. I need to turn the lights up in a minute here. I know I usually turn my gamma up pretty early, and that's because when you're doing stuff like this, you really need to be able to see at a distance, and it's kind of hard to do that. Come on, stop it. I'm trying to feed you. Must be hungry by now. But I wouldn't know, because you won't stop moving for... Okay. That didn't even go. There we go. Okay, now we're gonna back off and turn the gamma up. I know that's a little overly bright, but... walking around my mammoth. I'm still mad we lost that galley. That was in perfect position, too. But the game said no. You cannot have this galley. I mean, it's only a low level, and I wouldn't have done anything with it. I've learned the hard way you can't really take a low level galley out unless it has a lot of HP. Don't get me wrong, they're very, very fast, but there's always going to be situations where you can't simply run away. I actually lost my first galley within an hour of... Really? That really frustrates me is when you go to do anything and you just pick up rocks instead. I've actually dismounted animals sometimes and picked up stones at the same time. That's so stupid. But anyway, what was I talking about? I hear the turtle. There it is. No, stop it. I honestly lost my train of thought, so we're gonna talk about something else. Maybe. I am really trying to keep focused on keeping this thing fed. Come on. I'm pretty sure if I wasn't wearing a ghillie suit, this thing would have punched me halfway across the island like 6 times by now. But I'm not really sure, because I have no idea exactly how that effect works. See? I went to feed it and I picked up a rock. I'm gonna pick up every rock over here by the time this thing gets another berry. Again, this is stupid. Devs, please. Fix your game. Come on, I know you need another berry. Slow down. Stop. Stop moving. Thank you. No, that wasn't what we wanted to do. Like the because I don't want to try to run up behind it close enough to get a berry, because if you touch them, they will aggro you. Finally. Look at all these rocks we picked up just from following this thing around. I did not start with any rocks. Is that para bloody? Thought I was for a second. That's cause for concern. I mean, apes are pretty sturdy and they're known for being OP, but this is still a low level, and in any case, I don't want it raging across the island. Oh, there's another one. This is gonna be awkward. First of all, let's remember which one is the one we're taming. And second of all, how am I going to tame it if I have to worry about this other one in the way? Freezing. I have a torch, but it's very close to being broken. Oh, come on. Almost. Stop moving. Want to be my friend? I'll give you unlimited berries. And you get to throw me whenever you want. Come on. Whew. Again already. See, this is so inconsistent. Sometimes it'll take it minutes to get hungry, and other times it'll be like instant. I wonder if that's because of how long it's taking me to get at some of these berries, though. Let's see if it wants another one. Why must there be a cold front right now? My torch isn't going to be strong enough. I can only hope that, the temperature will go up. Before I freeze to death. Or that we will hopefully tame this before we freeze to death, because then I can at least make a campfire. No. That must be accounting for the lower timer between berries. No, stop that. That's really irritating. I thought for sure I was gonna pick that stupid rock up first. Okay. torch gonna be any use at all? Probably not. Is temperature going up or down? Either way, the torch isn't gonna work until it gets a little bit warmer. This is really not very good if we freeze to death before this thing is tamed. I have almost 50 for it now, too. Okay, phew. Temperature is definitely going back up. It's a good thing they aren't afraid of fire yet. We're so close. Hopefully that's going to hold us over until we finish this tame. Because obviously I don't want to eat the berries that I'm feeding to this ape. Got what? Is that two more bites? Two or three? Don't do that. Game. Para, get out of my way. Why must you walk in a circular motion? Okay. Alright, it looks like one more. That is really good news. Now it walks up onto the raft. No, don't get stuck on the railing. But do stay on the raft. That's actually really handy. Except now it's kind of circling around a lot, and that's going to be not good. It's that stupid turtle again, isn't it? Come on. One more. Thank you. Turtle? Oh, I was gonna say, for once, be useful and block this thing from walking. Come on. Can you stop moving? I swear I hit the button and it just didn't register. Come on. And I picked up a stone. There we go. Yes. So as you can see, that's the first ape I've ever tamed. I am extremely happy about that. Hello, Mrs. Ape. You are terrifying. Let me guess, you're gonna throw me. Oh, okay. Okay, so that's one animal down. So we have a Gigantopithecus. And actually, the video is running a little bit longer than I thought. So that's gonna be it for this episode. Thank you for joining me, and I will see you all in the next episode.